Okay everyone, Buzz Killington here, back to do another BuzzCast, and this one features two high ranking players once again. We have Hi, who's also known, better known perhaps as Baggio, and we have Alabaster, who is also known as Worker. Both players each having about 1100 Smurf accounts under their names. I'm going to go with Baggio and Worker, as that seems to be their main accounts. So, the game is on Het Platteland, both sides picked randomly, and without further ado, let's get things kicked off. So, as we see, Worker is Traveller 59 in red on the left, and we'll scroll across the map, and see that Baggio has ended up as a GDI faction, and let's see which one he's got. GDI Vanilla. So we have Traveller 59 versus GDI Vanilla. I wouldn't necessarily expect to see a Disintegrator Rush on a map this large, although they can be used to take out spikes, and we'll see if that's what he chooses to do in this case. So how many are we getting out? We have 1, 2, 3. I'd expect to see about 6. 6 is the minimum, really, to make it worth your while and to get the damage done. Going to take both his spikes. Oh, engineer walking through Tiberium there, but nothing to worry about. And yep, 6 Disintegrator squads out, and it looks like they are heading up north, probably to take out both the spikes. I'd expect that to be solved. There we go. Both spikes about to be captured, and the Disintegrators are on the move. So is Baggio going to have any idea that this is coming? That's the important question right now. We have a single rifleman squad going out down here. A buzzer swarm has captured that building there, giving him some much needed vision. Disintegrators are moving down the middle of the map. I would have expected them to come up here, but then again, if they had, Baggio would have caught them. So on go the Disintegrators. What's Worker going to do? Is he going to go for the spikes? Nope, he's backtracking completely. Nope, he's changed his mind. Nothing going, much going on there. He spotted them. Somehow Baggio spotted them. He's got APC out with an infantry squad in. 2 APCs. So that should definitely be enough. 3 APCs, a little bit of overkill. A single watchtower drop would have achieved some significant damage on those Disintegrators, but now it looks like this particular spike is going to die. That's almost the end of the spike. He can take that spike out. No, he's not. Is he going to get it? He is, but it's going to cost him pretty much all of his Disintegrators. So not the best use of the Disintegrators there, but on the other hand, Baggio did massively overspend with 3 APCs. Completely unnecessary. Let's see. 2 with rifle squads in. That was a big spend to deal with that, so perhaps it was all worthwhile. We have 5 harvesters out for Worker now. And Baggio, in the meantime, has 5 harvesters out as well. MCV expanded to the next space, next field rather. Another refinery going to come down there. Gunwalkers coming out to deal with the 3 APCs, wherever they are. Where might they be right now? It's a bit hard to spot orange on this map, unfortunately. There we go, found them. So I reckon, yep, it looks like Baggio is going to take a little bit of revenge and take down this spike, but the gunwalkers have found them. Excellent mine drop there by Baggio. That's made the difference there. The gunwalkers are pulling back. One should fall. Second should fall too. All 3 should go down. What's Worker's response? He's not building any more units. If he'd pushed off into that base, he could have done a few mine drops around the refinery. He's got some damage on the harvesters. But with tier 2 down, those APCs are going to have to retreat. Missed their chance to take out the spike there, unfortunately. but at the same time forced him to drop a lightning spike. So pretty even game so far. And look what we have here. We have tier 3 straight into a hexapod, even before an expansion to the next field. This is an interesting play. Meanwhile, Baggio has committed to eco build. He's got his two refineries down. He has 6 harvesters down there. Tier 2 AP ammo on the way. 6 harvesters there. 5 harvesters. 11 harvesters. He's definitely not going to be hurting for money. Mechapedes are out from the worker. 2 so far. Is that it? That appears to be 2 at the moment, going in for some harassment. At least they will when they eventually get there. I'm surprised nobody's claimed the EMP control center yet. Baggio knows, must know he can get that if he wants it. Hexapod now out. What's the gonna be a refinery there? Yep. Doesn't seem to be building any. He sold off his war factory. Doesn't seem to be building any corruptors to support that. So perhaps he's planning to go in for a lot of teleport spam, which is always annoying against travel players. In the meantime, the mechapedes have not been spotted, and they're coming in on some undefended harvesters. Good use of stasis here to slow down the response. Armory comes down for some reason. But in the meantime, one harvester is going to fall. Tanks are here now. Probably it wasn't necessary to shield that tech center, as the mechapedes wouldn't have had the time to take it down, but hey. This is an interesting choice for a hut. Obviously he's planning to switch into infantry, but there's the first barracks drop. Grenadiers coming out now. Mechapedes are going up to deal with the second spike. Or not. Off for a little stroll. Hexapod is on the move now. And we have everyone's favourite shock troopers coming out as well. 2 refineries down. Stasis chamber being kept around. Is Prodigy out yet though? That's a very slow build, so perhaps that's going to be a Prodigy in a moment. We'll keep an eye on that. Mammoth tanks out now from Baggio. I'd expect to see him expanding to here fairly soon. What are these mechapedes doing? They should be targeting this spike down. At the moment they're not achieving very much. There we go. There we go, there's the Prodigy. Question is, does the hexapod already have one? It might well already have a Prodigy in it. We'll see what'll happen in a little while. Worker expands to his next field. Just some infantry on Tiberium there. Mechapedes have decided to pull back and then go back in again for whatever reason. Railguns down for the Mammoths and the Predators. Baggio needs to expand. He needs to expand fairly soon. What's he doing? What's he building? Well, he's got the Reclamator Hub out, and this must be Tier 4 for his support power, so I'd expect it to be that. He knows the Hexapod is out, so that must be his counter. The Railgun Preds take down a Mechapede. Hammerheads are coming down as well. Let's see what this is.
Marv assembly complete.
Ah, there we are. There's Tier 4. The Marv is out. We're going to see this get sold. Is this going to be sold off in a second? Nope, he's opting to build all his infantry from there, which is probably a sensible strategy. This, on Het Platterlander, games tend to be long and linger for quite some time. Hammerhead's encountered the hexapod, but escaped with its life, which is surprising. But a large force moving in here. The hexapod can't deal with that. If he gets an MPOP. Ooh. Oh, that was dicey. I'm pretty sure that hexapod was emped when it was teleported away. But it was that quick that I don't think there was any intention behind that. As all of you should be aware, teleporting emped hexapods is very definitely a no-no. It's counted as a bug exploit. Another mechapede goes down, lightning spike goes down. The force there was just too large for it. That's going to be a refinery coming in to take advantage of that tip field. But Worker already has a refinery down, second refinery down. Hexapod back out, but We're going to see some teleport action in a minute, I think, as the Corruptors have pulled back. What do we have here? What's going on now? That Hammerhead should get some repairs, really. Is the airfield still around? Yep, there's no reason not to repair that one. I'd expect to see one of these refineries should have been sold off by now. These harvesters are long distance mining, which is not the best use. This refinery could be sold off as well, frankly. This armory probably isn't needed either. So Baggio perhaps not with the best use of his buildings at the moment. Hamhead's coming down to take out this building. What's this? Just some more infantry on Tiberium. Baggio isn't paying too much attention to his units at the moment. I'm not sure what he's doing. Some more disintegrators out. Okay, guys, you're focused. You can move on now. Now I think workers have forgotten that they're there. A couple of storm riders out. Going to take down this hammerhead, no problem. Hexapod out on a prowl. Let's see how many. There we are. We're just one field at the moment. Just storm riders. Do we have a tier 4 drop for Traveller yet? We do not. So we're not going to be seeing packs quite yet. Although that could still be on the cards, and packs are always fun to watch, if not necessary to play against. This harvest is going to fall unless I'm anti. Yep, here we go. Slingshots are out. They'll drive those away. One falls, two falls. Three go down. Three down. Three down for the three storm riders down for the loss of a single harvest, and not the best there. Are these disintegrators going to get a harvest to kill? They are. They're not, rather. They survive, but this lightning spike might still take a harvest to get that harvester out of the way. Oh, that's sloppy. That's sloppy play by Baggio. But in the meantime... EMP hits nothing, unless the hexapod was... Oh. That was definitely teleported while emped. Worker needs to watch that. In the meantime, he does have his rift generator down. I think we lost two harvesters there to a lightning spike, which is very careless from Baggio. Slingshots need to come in and deal with this lone storm rider while they can. This APC should be enough to convince it to go elsewhere. Took a hammerhead with it though. As I say, he definitely teleported that hexapod away while emped, which is a massive no-no. I'll keep an eye on that and see if he does it again. But as a rule, I'm prepared to believe it was an accident unless I know otherwise, especially if you're teleporting using your prodigy, you're on the other side of the map, you click, move across, then the emp comes down. It happens. A single Devastator warship out, but he's then gone back to... here we go. Tier 4 support power used, but that's not going to take out the Prodigy. In fact, the Prodigy is basically laughing at it. Three Corruptors down, but... And an airstrike coming in, but the Prodigy's moved. So that seems to be... That was a complete waste of a support power, really. Three Corruptors. We now have two Gravity Stabilizers down. Stormrider's back out again. Some slight damage on the drone platform. Really not worth it there. That wasn't a good use of support powers at all. Gunwalkers here are going to die. And in the meantime, Baggio's taking this field. And some long distance mining going on here. But if he moves forward, he can deny that field to Worker as well. But Worker seems to show no interest in going for it right now. Got his hexapod coming in. And a large force of Stormriders. But the upgraded turrets are there to greet them. One falls, the rest are pulling back. Slow stasis comes down, which has basically missed the hammerhead, so it's not going to achieve a great deal. Is he going to be able to... Oh, there we go. Teleported away again. No corruptors available to heal it, but it doesn't matter particularly right now. Yeah, this was a bit of a waste of a support power on Worker's part now. So what is Baggio going to do about this? Reverse moving his Marv, which is reverse moving everything apparently. Turn those around, I'll go a little bit faster. Lightning Spike comes down, Storm Riders are swept around and flanked. Power plant's gonna go down. Nope. Not sure the Hammerhead's engaging the Storm Riders is the best plan in the world. Three slingshots there. Should be chasing them down, really, or at least keeping an eye on what they're doing. Ruptors are back out now, and Hexapod is up to full health. Baggio needs a lot of Emp Grenadiers out, and he needs them out now. Harvester falls. But there's a large force down here that isn't particularly achieving very much. Slingshots and more mammoths are moving. Why is he reverse moving absolutely everything? Seems a bit pointless. Gunwalker scouting force pushing in, but it's not going to get very much done. Another refinery could be sold off here. That should probably be repaired. Still two refineries here. Still two refineries here. Still that, not the best base management from Baggio, it has to be said, this game. But in the meantime, he's got his eco secured on this field. What's this going to be? Well, we'll wait and see what that is in a moment. Storm Riders came in, but the slingshots are waiting for them. They're ranking up nicely, but one is down to fairly low health, so that could fall if he's not careful. That was probably just another power plant. When are we going to see that? A sonic drop somewhere? Perhaps more anti-air somewhere. I expect that's what it was. Okay, this large force here is wasting its time at the moment. It should need to push in, really. Should engage this hexapod, at least force it to get teleported back. Hammerheads are coming in. It's a bit frustrating in a way because, yep, there it goes. Straight back here. Nine tripods waiting to greet them. But they are traveller tripods, the weakest tripods of all. But in those kind of numbers, it doesn't really matter. Worker is quite happy to sit back and do nothing while his rift generator counts down to firing. Baggio absolutely needs to push in now because Worker knows where his force is, and if I was Worker, I would take out that whole army. That whole army could be taken out of the rift generator quite easily. But what is he going to do? So Disintegrator's there, probably trying to sneak around, but no, he's pulling back again. He doesn't have much here. He's given him time to get the air defences down, so he's probably working what he can do. More Storm Riders out. Baggio is playing this far too cautiously. He's letting the Traveller player build up far too much strength. Devastation comes in. Is it going to get away? Just escapes. Storm Riders are coming in, but we have two towers down to three. Turrets down. And a sling. Three slingshots. Bad engagement for Worker there, but perhaps just keeping Baggio from pushing into his base while he waits for the countdown to finish. Hexapod walking around supported by the Corruptors now, so perhaps it won't be teleported away quite so quickly this time. Baggio needs to engage. He's got a large force here. He can push into it. What's he building on the backside of this? Some more Hammerheads. I would have expected to see Firehawks by now. Firehawks are absolutely deadly against any Scrim faction because they simply can't fence their buildings. Where's his tier 3? His tier 3 is there. That could easily get taken out. You wouldn't even have the Strato Fighter in. The Empire's been taken out. Yep, numbers of the Storm Riders were just too great there. Oh, Rift Generator is almost done. I'm going to keep keeping an eye on this now to see where Worker chooses to target. Baggio splitting his forces up sensibly, but he should have pushed in before now, to be honest, because he's going to take losses that he didn't need to. Let's see if... The tension. This field is huge, so I'm probably going to miss the initial moment. We can come in here, take out... There we go, beautiful. Hammerheads go down. EMP Hexapod this time is not getting teleported away, but that Rift Generator use was deadly. Absolutely chewed through the forces that could stop it. Are these Grenadiers? Come on, my critical Grenadier's better. The Grenadiers could EMP this. Come on. Come on, Baggio, get after it. EMP it, lock it down while you get your forces there. You could take the Hexapod out. Oh, he's remembered now, but I think it's too late. think it's too late to save that. Corruptors are pulling back. A couple of tripods moving out to provide some support, but he's not going to get that hexapod down now. It's just going to get teleported away. In the meantime, the tripods are pushing in. Zone troopers, drop pods comes down. But Buzzer Swarm is waiting to greet them, but achieving nothing. Those two tripods are outmatched. Yeah, Baggio has wisely abandoned chasing the hexapod down in favour of destroying the tripods, but oh, this massive tripod force pushing in now. I think that was the MCV went down. It was. Nice use of the M support power, but the stasis comes down to delay those. But the hammerheads should be able to take. No, the gunwalkers might be able to take them down in turn, to be honest. Mixed bag there, saw a tripod getting teleported away. But the anti-air is now down, and he's not going to allow him to take those tripods, I wouldn't think. But we do have quite a strong force coming in now, but it is delayed by the stasis. What's he going to deal with? He's got pressure on both sides. Those tripods should really push in and at least recapture. I'd expect to see a portal come down to recapture those husks. Baggio's attention is elsewhere right now. Hexapod got teleported away, leaving the Corruptors to chase after it. Come back, Dad. Come back. Baggio's content to trample all over the tripods, or perhaps that was by accident. Does he have an MCV back out yet? He doesn't have one out quite yet. That must be that building now, but he seems to be a little bit stalled for cash. Only one harvester on that field. Nope, two redeploying now. Perhaps he's not managing his harvests very effectively. Again, salt sell your refinery, man. You don't need it. The main force has opted to push in. Some long distance mining going down here. Oh, don't step on the heart. Oh, that's just careless. He's losing husks that he could capture. In the meantime, the hexapod is going to chew through that mammoth. Is this grenadier going to be able to get an EMP down? Come on, come on. Where's the M? Where's the M? Oh, sloppy, sloppy. Hexapod escapes, but only just. Only just escapes with its life there. That prodigy is doing super work for a worker. Super work for a worker. Does he have an MCV back out? He must have an MCV back out. Oh, there we are. It's redeploying to the front. I'm surprised neither side has gone multi-MCV. This is a common strategy on this field, on this map rather. Some more long distance harvesting going on, but it's very difficult to starve out a sprint player. They have the tier 2. That looked like a complete miss there. Another squandered support power from Baggio. The Storm Rider's going to be like, right, you want to take it that way? We're going to come and get some damage done. But they're going to pull out of there while they can. More slingshots, more anti-air. They're not getting in there. What's this? He's stalled for cash. He needs a refinery here. He needs a refinery here. Laser fence while he can. But in the meantime, a massive tripod force supported by the hexapod, which can heal very fast, in fairness. It's pushing forward, and it seems that Worker is going for the old air defense base creep approach to deny Baggio some flexibility that his air affords him. I wonder where that M came down from. Surprising, this doesn't seem to be anything there. I'm not sure how that got M'd. Did the tripod M the thunderstep? Not the weirdest thing I've ever seen. But in the meantime, we have a substantial tripod force here. Yeah, get those hammerheads back. Screen anti-air is absolutely deadly when it's fully teched up. Very large force of zone troopers pushing in. Hexapod has to be phased to save it. Corruptors are going to go down, but in the meantime, tripods are pushing in and the Storm Riders are coming too. This is going to be an epic confrontation here. doesn't have the anti-air here to save him from his horses from those storm riders. That's the problem. Tripods are coming in and their Emperor is going to deal with this far quite easily, I would say. In the meantime, Hexapod is pushing in, getting some crushes on. That's 1, 2, 3 Mammoths taken out. That goes to Marv. The Marv's dead. If Baggio had the Storm Riders there, that could have made some difference. And, if Baggio had had some anti-air there, some slingshots to deal with the Storm Riders. But in the meantime, Worker continues his advance. Exopod starting to rank up nicely, and there's only another minute until the next use of the Rift Generator. Storm Riders go down. Again, not the best use of the support powder we've ever seen. Surely you would have taken out these tripods here, but or targeted the actual units attacking your base. Zone troopers are coming in, but there's not enough here to deal with this, and the gunwalkers can take them out. What's Badger's answer going to be? Now, it looks like another Marv coming up, but he's absolutely stalled for cash. This tip is going completely unharvested. Again, sell your refinery, dude. Sell your harvester. Sell one of those. Oh, it's too late. It's too late now. He doesn't have enough harvesters out to make this work for him, really. MCD goes going to go down. There it goes. I reckon this is going to be it for Baggio now. He can't handle this. Zone Trooper drop pod comes in again, but where is the Rift Generator going to hit now? I perhaps target these two here, take out the two refineries. It certainly doesn't need it for that one. That's that field down. Single Mammoth comes in, but it's not going to get anything done. Airstrike comes in. Misses beautifully. Mammoth goes down. Where is that Rift Generator going to hit? That's the question. Probably not going to hit here now because he's pushing in with his forces. He doesn't need to squander it on this. He needs to get his harvesters out of there. There we go. It's gone. He's sold his harvesters. He's running. He needs to get them back up here and start harvesting this field. Planning defensive measures. Doesn't have the anti-air to deal with this Storm Rider. Is that going to fall? Nope. Gets away. Harvesters are running, but it's hard to see what Baggio can do in the face of this. Oh, what happened? Ah, just in time, just in time. Look at that Mammoth doing a little jiggle, but it did not save him from getting sucked into space. That must be it now. I don't think he has an MCV out. Nope, he doesn't have an MCV out. He didn't get one out in time. EMP comes down, but it's just prolonging the inevitable. He's as good as dead now. This superhero zone trooper isn't going to do anything at all. You tried your best, mate. You had the high ground, but it just wasn't enough. Single harvester. He's not building anything. He knows it's over. I'd expect the GG come in any time now. Drone ships coming in, just sitting there. Ideally would like to deploy that sometime soon. Stasis comes in just to add insult to injury. He knows he's done. His power's down. Tripods are coming in. Is drone ship going to fall? I guess Worker just doesn't care anymore. He can always rebuild it. That refinery is down. He has no means of producing infantry apart from his own troops again. But it's not going to get anything done. Oh, he's remembered to deploy. That's a shame. I was hoping that would fall. Quite entertaining. Zone Troopers doing a valiant last stand dealy, but they don't have the firepower to take down a hexapod anyway. And it's just going to get teleported away any second now, so it really doesn't matter. Tripods are moving. Going to deal with the last of the units. Here's the hexapod going to get... Nope! Phase comes down, Buzz Swarm comes in, that's the end of Baggio. He's done. Game over. Thank you and good night. But he's absolutely dragging it out for as long as he possibly can, apparently. Four tripods coming in, going to die if they don't target that base defense down, which they're not. Oh, they've remembered it's there now. But not in time to save two of them from dying. A little bit careless there from Worker, but I suppose his attention is elsewhere. Next set of balls. Base defense will drop, and now it's just down for this. And that's it. Baggio finally throws in the towel. Well, decent game. Baggio was played too defensively, and he paid for it, to be honest. He should have pushed in a lot sooner before he lost all those forces to not one but two Rift Generator uses. Oh, skipped the wrong button. Oh well. As I say, he missed his chances there. He should have pushed in a lot sooner. Built more Grenadiers to deal with that Hexapod, although we frown at Worker for teleporting that empty Hexapod away, but prepared to believe it was probably unintentional there. Perhaps if Baggio had gone for Firehawks and coupled with a more aggressive strategy, it might have worked a little bit better for him, but he gave the screen player too much leeway, and in the end you can't afford to do that with Traveller 59. Or with any screen faction. And with that, that's another BuzzCast finished. So if, as always, if you enjoyed the video, feel free to check out the other videos on my channel and like and subscribe. I'll be doing videos every 2 or 3 days, as I say. I think it's been perhaps 2 days since my last video. We're probably going to keep to this pattern at the moment. If you have any games that you'd like to be cast by me, then drop me a message, either in the thread on game replays or via a direct message there. And I also stream Kane's Wrath and probably some other games when I can be bothered to stream them on my Twitch channel, which is twitch.tv/LordBuzzKillington. Alright then, hope you enjoyed the video. Until next time.